In this tutorial, I'll show you how to generate the vertices and indices needed to render a plane that can also be, well, non-planar. Let's start off by making a square plane that starts from the origin. We could make it out of two triangles, but then we wouldn't be able to change its inner parts in any way. So we instead want it to be made out of a bunch of squares, which are themselves made out of a bunch of triangles. Now we can work with the inner parts as we see fit. Here's the code I used to generate the vertices you see. The function takes an integer div, representing the number of divisions per one side of the square, and the width of the whole plane. We can then think of our vertices as being part of rows and columns, and loop over all of them. Notice how there is one more vertex than divisions per side. We can now calculate the vertex we are on by multiplying the row and column by the width of one of our small triangles. Another way of thinking about this is multiplying and adding two vectors together. So this will give us the vertices, which we can then draw using points like so. If you try drawing them using triangles, you'll get some interesting results. We don't need to generate the indices, which will dictate how these points connect. To do that, we can look at a small example. We can now see that when going up a point, we add the number of divisions plus one to the index we are currently on, and when going left or right, we simply add or subtract 1. Knowing this, we can loop over the different rows and columns and get the indices for the top triangles and the bottom triangles of each row. Notice that I don't go over the last row and column, since these vertices don't form any triangles to the right or top of them. Using these vertices, we can now draw the actual plane using triangles. So that's nice and all, but this method is limited, since we're making a square and we're also bound to a plane, the XZ plane in this case. If we want to mold the shape of our plane and go into three dimensions, we must first look at a line. Here we have a majestic line that is made out of multiple vertices. In order to define this line, we'll have a starting vertex, ending vertex, and a number of divisions. If we subtract the starting vertex from the ending vertex, we'll get a vector that spans the line perfectly. We can then divide this vector and add multiples of it together to get all the points. So why did we take time to make a line? That's because another way you can think about making a plane is by using a bunch of lines that then you read using the indices we generated beforehand, since the order of the line vertices is the same as the order of the vertices we generated using our first square function. The cool thing is that we can manipulate the starting and ending positions of these lines in order to make any convex shaped quadrilateral. So for the function, we want to take in all four vertices of the plane and a division number. We then calculate the two sides and divide them up. Then simply loop over all the rows, adding the vertices of the lines to our plane. And there you have it. What's really cool about this is that you can also make the input vertices be non-planar, and you'll get an interesting shape out of it. Let's now look at how to add other useful vertex properties to this, starting with texture coordinates. This is really easy, since you simply need to divide the current row and column by the division number. To get the normals, you need to calculate these two vectors and take their cross product. The tangent is the normalized version of this vector, and the bitangent is simply the cross product between the normal and tangent, or tangent and normal, depending on the coordinate system you use in tangent space. I should also note that the algorithm I used here can also be implemented in a compute shader to speed up the procedural generation at high division levels. If you don't know how to use compute shaders, check out my tutorial on that for OpenGL. That was it for this tutorial. Make sure to hop onto my Discord server if you feel like it, and of course, a special thanks to my Patreons. As always, all relevant links are in the description. Bye!